have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, never would have made it. Never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through, I can see that you are the one I held on to, and I never,
never would have made it.
Oh, I never could have made it.
Mother, cousin, And you are a testament of how good of a friend she was. This is one of my very best friends. I'm gaining strength from some of my lifelong friends. Shannon, Jody, Tola, Gayla. We've been around a long time. God takes those that are ready and He leads us here to get it right. Because my best friend made her calling and her election sure.
This wife, this daughter, this cousin, Lord God, we ask and we invoke your presence. Lord, we ask that you send your comfort, that you send your peace, and you send your joy. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. But most of all, we ask that you send your anointing. Lord, that your Holy Ghost fall down right now. and be every comfort that we need. Oh God, we're looking to you right now. Oh God, as we help to celebrate this life, oh God, that you strengthen the Johnson family and strengthen the Haley family. Oh God, as they go through this, let them know that they're not alone. Oh God, but you promise never to leave nor forsake us. And that despite their weeping may endure for a night, Lord, joy comes in the morning. Lord, touch every song that goes forth. Lord, everything that happens in this service. Lord, let you be glorified and edified. That your strength and that your healing power will comfort this family. Oh God, and we bless and glorify your holy name. We will look to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. The one when we look to the hills with which cometh our help, we know that our help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and the earth. Lord, we thank you for this life. We thank you, Lord, for how she is able to bring people together. Oh God, the laughs, Lord, the smiles, the comforting words that she's given us. Lord, they will never be forgotten. We will hold on to these memories. Lord, and we thank you for her life. We thank you, Lord, for her life. Oh God, how she looked to you and you gave her the supernatural healing. We thank you, God, and we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jehovah Shalom. Hearts are heavy. Heads are bowed. Tears are falling. We need your strength right now. Jehovah Shalom. Release your gentle rain to rest upon the hurting hearts. Conquer the pain.
Shonda,
we need your peace.
Yes.
lives, we can give God the praise, the glory, and the honor for a life well lived, for the time that He lent this wonderful daughter to us on today. Certainly, we give God deference, respect, and honor, and great appreciation for the one that woke us up this morning and started us on our way. Anybody thankful that you still have God's life? Just lay your hands on your neighbor and tell him, I thank God that I still yet have life. To this husband, to this mother, to these children, to these grandchildren, to these siblings, and to this Johnson family, it is an honor to stand here to be with you at this time. When I first got here to Sanders Temple, we thank God for Mother Benika Davis being here. Amen. The widow of our former pastor. Thank God for Mother Davis being here on today. I did not have the privilege of knowing Sean like many of you, but I had the privilege of knowing her mother. Anybody in here, thank God that you have a good mother. Yeah. You came here to Sanders Temple and Sister Betty Johnson entreated me and she said, Pastor, I have a daughter that's healed and I need you to pray. Need you to pray that God would touch her body. Need you to pray that God would heal her body. And though we had expectations and though we had desires, and though we had wishes, we had hopes and we had dreams, you better believe it, God did just that. He took her from this world.
That's my wife's name. I'm only saying what Sister Jessie Latimer would say. Even though I look all right, but I don't look that good. My wife is not here. And like I said, she's in Milwaukee taking care of some business with our family. But Beth, trust me when I tell you. But I never say anything that I never mean. If I don't mean it, I won't say it. If I don't love you, you'll never hear me say I love you. If I'm not praying for you, you'll never hear me say I'm praying for you. But when I tell you I'm praying, I'm praying. When I tell you I love you, I love you. And Sister Betty, Brother Robert, Brianna, trust me. We pray for y'all. We pray for y'all. Night and day, we pray for y'all. God bless you.
Joy comes in the morning. Weep now, but we got joy. Some can't hear nothing I'm saying, but y'all can. Get your life right if you ain't got it right. God loves each and every one of us.
Bless the Lord today. Belong to the Lord. Belong to my family. Amen. My cousin Betty, and my husband Rob, to all of the family. I'm saying God bless you. Let me just remind you of a scripture that Jesus said in the 11th chapter of St. Matthew, around the 24th, 25th verse. He says that I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Now give honor to God, to the family. The house has been addressed. Amen. We're praying for you, Sister Betty. Praying for you. Amen. Man of God. I remember the scripture said that death is swallowed up in victory. You know, we had social media, we got a lot of things. I didn't realize Sister Sean was going through what she was going through until I got some information and saw a post. But I know that if we're going to be able to curse cancer, you can't use the devil's words to curse it. Because sickness comes from the devil. So if we're going to get rid of sickness, we're going to have to use the one that has the power over every sickness, and his name is Jesus. So now if we're going to be able to have victory over whatever is going on in our bodies, whatever we've been diagnosed with, whatever our family's been diagnosed with, there is a remedy. And it's called Jesus. And those 39 stripes that were on his back was not just for a headache, but it was for incurable diseases. Because I've seen people healed miraculously because of the power of God. Now, Sister Sean may have been tired and she had a good husband, good family, And it's challenging when you're going through pain consistently and people say they're praying for you, but you're not feeling it. But when you actually know that God is a healer and you have a better home on the other side, then sometimes you opt out for plan A. Just go ahead and just take me, and then I'll see my children when they get the glory. And so what I want to encourage you is that if you don't have Jesus, see, this is what separates the pros from the cons. See, we can go to church, but in this time, you need Jesus, because he is the only one that can help you with this tragedy or with this sorrow. And because the Bible said death is swallowed up in victory, there are some of us who are attached to Jesus that understand the greater plan. And for a few moments, you're going to feel the glory, because we have the faith to know that God is a healer. And once we close our eyes here, we just wake up on the other side. And even though we're separated, amen, our spirit may be separated from the body, but our soul belongs to God. And I want you to know that if you don't have Jesus, amen, you just need to receive him so that you can be with Jesus in eternity. And the sad piece is you get to see all your friends. We're praying for you. We love you. Keep the faith. Glory to God. Amen. I remember when Sean was calling me and dealing with Andre when he was sick, and she gave me what the Lord had given you in a dream. And I said, oh, she gave consolation. God gave the consolation. I'm praying that God gives you consolation for this child as well. Amen. And that God will take you through and strengthen you so that you can help other mothers and help other people get through these things. Because God is a refuge in the present help and a time of trouble. And remember these five words: death is swallowed up in victory. You don't have to feel it, just know that victory is on your side. Look at your neighbor and say, I got victory working for me.
Razor blade and cut it in.
Right.
And we wore waterfalls to match
and everything we had on. And back in that day when I thought I was grown, and I remember I showed up at home with some burgundy hair. And I found out that my body didn't belong to me. My mother said, "Who in the world told you you could dye your hair?" And that's exactly what I said. I laughed because he was talking about how clean that they used to be. And I remember Wayne and Andre, when their suits would get too little, we cut them in the shorts. And so one of them, I guess, thought he could still fit his, that Andre. He told on us. And we had his suits, and we took his hats. And so by that time, we had split up in different high schools. And so Sean would have it on one week at Broad Ripple. I'd wear it to Pike the next week. JoJo had it on at Tech or North Central the next week. And Andre would say, "I'm getting y'all." And Beth say, "Chill." To Sean, "Why could y'all cut up the Andre suit?" And tell where's his hat? I said, "Well, he did so and so." Tell you stop lying on the Andre. Honey, the Andre and Dwayne did no wrong. But if they said Tia and Sean did, y'all fast ends, you did. All I know is it's good to have a praying mother. It's good to have a praying aunt. It's good to have people that will pray for you, labor over you. Because look at us now.
And she showed it by the respect she showed them. She always respected us, and whatever we asked her to do, she would do it. She never got sassy. She never said a smart word to you. She never told you, "I'm grown, Uncle Stevie." Whatever you asked her to do, she would do it. And she just had a sweet spirit. And I love me some Sean, and I will love her forever. And I thank God for all of our relatives. If you connected to the family, just stand up. I want y'all to see our family, part of our family. If you connected to the family, come on, stand up. Advise you, if you're not connected, don't mess up. Not here and there. And this is not all of us. This is just a small portion of us. And we are grateful for being here. I'm going to try to do something. I had planned on doing another song, but I see no other musician is here. And I'm an antique musician. On the organ anyway. Give me my guitar, I'll tell you something different. I'm gonna try to do this. I'm gonna just do an old simple song everybody can help me do. Everybody's, I know I got a piece of a pop in it. I got a whole pop in it. I see nothing but things. Y'all know this. If y'all would, y'all help me out. If y'all understand. Thank you.
I thank God for my cousin Rob and, you know, Brianna and all of our family. Y'all, we need Jesus. And like Sister Jill was saying earlier, she said that she and Sean would mark the saints in the back of the church. Well, we were all raised the same, and I was thinking about it a few days ago on my job. And the Lord took me back to when we were children and they would come to Mississippi. And my cousin Nene, he'd be a preacher in the Lord Andre. And we'd have our own little choir, you know, and he'd anoint us, and he said, "Now when I touch you, I want you to fall." You know, I thank and praise God for how, you know, we were all raised the same in this way, and I thank God for this way. I thank and praise God for, you know, how I remember my auntie calling me and telling me how Sean, you know, had gave her life to the Lord, and, you know, I thank God for that. You know, we went from playing to church to actually in church. And as I was thinking, you know, about our childhood days, the Lord brought this song of praise to my heart. And I'm like, you know, I'm a little hoarse, and I'm a little, you know, I'm excited about Jesus, and I'm excited about, you know, Sean's deliverance, because, you know, I trust God. I trust him, and I know that she trusts him also. I learned, yes, how to live holy. And I
cracked up, like we really would have been on the phone for hours laughing at this. We was real childish and petty. Okay. Many of us can say that we endured a lot of pain in our lifetime, but I can say from experience that Shine dealt with a lot and never let it keep her from being the amazing mother, sister, daughter, friend, cousin, and ultimately the wife. She took on the role of being the bridge between estranged family members, all while laughing and planning family functions. I stand before you today with the most difficult task I've ever had to complete, because she was so much more to me than my cousin. She was my sister, and I was her shadow. Like, her shadow never got a chance to cast on the ground because I was behind her. So since she amen and in the corner, let me tell you about Tia and Sean. I believe they tried to kill me one day. We walked across 46th and Edmondson, remember Tia? The trussle? And I don't know what it was, but I could see White River underneath it. I wasn't walking across there. they laughed at me so hard. I was only 8 years old. These people laughed real, real hard at me. I'm not walking across there because y'all trying to kill me. Y'all can push me in. I can't swim. And to this day, I will not walk across anything that I can see underneath. Tia and Sean did that. And I wasn't supposed to tell, but I'm telling today. From the haircuts and burns, yep, she was burning since like, girl, that was just grease. Part of the green bar, she would flip your skin to that and say, it was grease. Now why are you curling my hair with grease? And me being the dummy that I was, I believed her, knowing that she didn't just grease my scalp. But whatever she said, I believed it. Laughing to cussing kids. For some reason, the lady thought kids cussing was hilarious. She would crack up. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul is resting. And it's a blessing. Yeah.
God to come into your house just one more time. Lord, we thank you. Because your word said that in all things we should give thanks. Lord, we're not thankful for this occasion. We're thankful in this occasion.
That's it.
Lord, we thank you that you're on her life and that she's resting in your arms. Now we ask that you would give strength today. Give us strength in our hearts. Amen. Give us a word of encouragement. Give us a word of peace. Most of all, God, touch somebody's heart today. Give us a word that will prick someone's heart, that they might come crying and asking the question, what must I do to be saved? Save somebody today. And Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
Once we arrive at the cemetery, if you'll all come directly to the back of the hearse to carry Shine to her final resting place. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much.
And ladies, if you could get to the front, closer to the front of the procession.
We are. We parked right here. We can come behind you.
All right. Thank you.
So should we be?
Hey, what's going on? What's up, baby mama?
Yeah, you good?
Yep.
Come on, go.
Hey, buddy.
You need to get my number.
Okay.
I mean,
Eric, are you coming to the store?
Yes, ma'am. I thought you said Chinese. Her name is Chinese too?
No. Hey, yes.
Hey, yeah, no, okay. All right, cousin.
Okay. Man, I ain't seen all y'all together in a minute.
Yeah, long time.
Cut that beard off.
What's up, baby? Okay, y'all see they run through the whole neighborhood.
I said the Trey Folks didn't get together again.
He don't need ya.
And I brought the window of the park.
Yeah, he said it means to all of them.
I brought the window of the park.
Thank you.
Where is Rob?
Changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Would you repeat after me, Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Just wanna make it to heaven.
Trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation.
Just wanna make it in.
Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
I just wanna cross that river. My Lord, I wanna be free from sin. Oh.